Hello and welcome to Skitty Animates. I'm Skitty and today I'm going to teach you how to use this fantastic Maya plugin called Studio Library. So let's get started. First, let's talk about what Studio Library is useful for. It allows you to save poses, animations, as well as selection sets to an organized directory so you can paste them in your shots whenever and wherever you want. Let's start with how to navigate the tool. When you first open the library, it should look pretty empty. I've already been using the plugin, so I have a few folders over on the left bar here. I recommend organizing your poses by character, so go ahead and right-click in this left sidebar, go to New, and hit Folder. Name the folder with the character's name and hit Enter. You can also create folders with this plus button up top if you'd rather. You'll likely be creating multiple subfolders for each character, so you can keep things like your poses and animations separate. So select the character folder you created, right-click, and hit New Folder again. The folder will become a subfolder to whichever one you have selected. Name this one Selections. Now in your viewport, select a group of controls you find yourself manually selecting a lot. Maybe it's all of the left arm controls, or the face controls, or maybe it's her nose and her baby toe. I'm not here to judge. When you have them selected, either right-click the Selection subfolder, click the plus button with Selections highlighted, or right-click in the big window with Selections highlighted. Go to New and hit Selection Set. Now the bar on the right should be active. Without deselecting anything, go back to your viewport and position the camera for a screenshot of this selection set. Once it's in position, hit the Screenshot button. Now we can add a name and hit Save. If you hit Save and then think, "Oh no, I selected her nose and her baby toe, but I forgot her left eyeball." Don't fret. All you have to do is add the control you missed to your selection, right-click the saved version, and go to Edit Overwrite. You can take a new snapshot if you need to and hit Save again. Now if you deselect everything, you can click your selection set and hit Apply anytime you need them. You can also just double-click the set if you're lazy like me. Now that we have something that we can view in the library, we can talk about some interface preferences. Going left to right on the top bar, beside plus, we have a search bar in case you add way too many things to keep track of. Beside it, we have what looks like a martini glass. Don't ask me, I didn't make it. Which lets us hide items from the main window by type. Folders are hidden by default since they're kind of redundant. Next, we have three lines with circles, which allows us to change the icon size, put a border around each one, or add space between them. You can also change where the text is or hide it altogether. Next to that, we have what looks like a calendar, which changes how the folders are grouped. Next to that is your typical sort by options, and next we have a window icon that hides and unhides the sidebars. Beside that is a refresh button in case you download poses and put them in your computer's files manually while Maya is still running. Lastly, we have a settings menu, but the only unique option we need here is the second one, settings. This lets you set up where your library is storing information, lets you scale DPI, and most importantly, lets you customize both the top bar and background colors. Now let's try making and adding a pose. It's best to think in terms of what poses do I see myself using a lot, or what's a generic pose that I could use as a starting point for other poses. For myself, I find adding lip sync shapes, hand poses, generic facial expressions, and idle body poses are the most useful. So I'm gonna go ahead and pose out a quick body idle to add. Once you have your pose ready, select the controls you used. Don't be lazy in this instance and drag select your whole character though. If you add every control to the library, you create the possibility of overwriting things like, say, if you already posed out a facial expression or lip sync. Manually select them or use a selection set. Then with the folder selected you're adding the pose to, either click the plus up at the top or right click in the main window and hit New Pose. Take your screenshot, add a name, and hit Save. Now we have a pose in the library, but how do we use it? To simply paste the pose, it works the same as the selection sets. Just double click to add to the control you have selected. Yes, this means you can pick and choose which controls get pasted on. Or if you click on the pose once, there's a couple of options in the paste menu. We can choose whether or not the pose sets a key. We have the option to mirror the pose, though you won't be able to yet, and I'll get into that shortly. And we have search and replace, which works similar to mirror. Depending on your character's naming convention, you can tell the pose to search for the left side and replace it to the right side. We also have this namespace option down here. This is in case you want to paste to a different character that has the same rig setup. From File, uses the naming convention you saved the pose with. From Selection, we'll paste to the character you have selected. And Use Custom, you can select any additional character in your scene using the drop-down menu. Once we have all that set how we want, we have this slider we can use instead of hitting Apply, which is super cool. I use it all the time. What it does is blend your character's current position into the saved library pose. Say you you wanted your character to be mildly angry, but you only have an extreme anger pose in the library. If you use this slider, you could paste it at only 20 to 30%, so it isn't such a strong pose. If you want a simpler method, you can middlemost drag to blend the poses instead. Now let's talk about that mirror function. By default, this option isn't available because the library needs to be told how your character is set up first. To do this, it's going to create a library entry, so decide where you want that information to go. I recommend either adding it to your selections folder, or what I've done is add it straight to the main character folder. With the folder you want to add it to selected, click the plus up at the top again, and hit mirror table. Select your whole character this time, make your screenshot, and now we need to tell it what axis to mirror. For Dana here, Y is the up and down axis, and Z is the one pointing in front of her, so her mirror plane will be on the YZ. The left and right side boxes may fill themselves in if the library detects your naming scheme, but essentially, the asterisk represents the variable part of the name, followed by underscore L or underscore R. If your character is set up to have L and R written before the control name, yours should say L underscore asterisk and R underscore asterisk. Once you figure that out, hit save. Now we can go test out the mirror option on our saved poses. This really speeds up the process when putting hand poses in the library because you only have to pose them once, transferred to the other hand, and then hit save again. Lastly, let's talk about adding animation to the library. At this point, the process should feel pretty straightforward to you. Select the controls you want to add, hit the plus button with the folder you are adding to selected, and hit animation. In the right-hand tab, we have a familiar setup, but this time taking a screenshot actually creates a really low quality video. The by frame option is for the snapshot video. If you set the number to 2, it will only record every second frame, helping it save faster. Set the frame range of your animation before hitting the snapshot button, and let it calculate. Video will be taken from whatever viewport is active. You have the option to bake the keys when you save it, but I wouldn't recommend it. Give it a name and hit save. Now let's look at pasting the animation in your scene. Connect will attach it to your existing animation, and current time will paste it to wherever you are in the time slider. Under source, you can change the time frame to take a piece of the animation instead of all of it if you want, and under option, we have a couple of, well, options. Replace does what it sounds like. It replaces your current animation with the library one. Replace all replaces all of your animation. Be careful with this one. Insert squeezes the library stuff in the middle of your existing animation, and merge puts the animation on top of your existing stuff. You'll probably be sticking to replace for the most part. Select your namespace the same as before, and hit apply. So, do you think you can use the library on your own yet? Play around with it, have fun, and consider adding it to your workflow. At this point, I'd be lost without it. Leave a comment below if there's something you didn't understand. Like and subscribe if you learned something. Links to socials are in the description, and remember to always use a reference.